You may talk and sing and boast about your Fenians and your clans, and how the boys from County Cork bit up the black and tans. But I know a little codger who came out without a scar. Woo! His name was Paddy Mulligan, the man from Mullinger. The pillars chased him out of Connemara for beating up the valley in Stan O'Hara. And when he came to Ballymoe, he stole the parson's car, and he sold it to the bishop in the town of Castlebar. 700 pillars couldn't match him. The chief sent out the Arners for to catch him. And when he came to Dublin town, he stole an armoured car, and he gave it to the IRA brigade at Mullingar. Well, the peelers got their orders to suppress the man at sight, so they sent for reinforcements through the country left and right. 3,000 men surrounded him, they hunted near and far, but he was with the IRA in Johnson's motor car. The peelers chased him out of Connemara for beating up the valley of Stan O'Hara. But when he came to Ballymoe, he stole the parson's car, but he sold it to the bishop in the town of Castlebar. 700 peelers couldn't match him. The chief sent out the Arners for to catch him. And when he came to Ballytown, he stole an armored car, and he gave it to the IRA brigade at Mullingar.
They came with tanks and armored cars, they came with all their might. Them peelers never counted on old Paddy's dynamite. From the 13th day of April, well, he blew them to July, and the name of Paddy Mulligan was the girls of Ireland's eye.
The peelers chased him out of Connemara for beating up the valley of Stan O'Hara. And when he came to Ballymoe, he stole the parson's car, and he sold it to the bishop in the town of Castlebar. 700 peelers couldn't match him. The chief sent out the Arners for to catch him. And when he came to Dublin town, he stole an armored car, and he gave it to the IRA brigade.